Hi there. I'm your host today for this lounge car session. My name is Pam Hassan, and we are so pleased to present the Orchestra North Academy Quintet. I'll just briefly introduce our players here. We have Aaron on violin, Roxy also on violin. We have Thomas on viola, Julian on viola, and lastly, we have Nick on cello. They're going to play two pieces for us today. The first is a classic Dvorak double viola quintet, and take it away. Thank you.
So just as a little introduction to this Dvorak piece, this is in a very classical style in four movements. And what's interesting about this is in four movement style, often the second movement is quite contrasting in tempo. The first one we just played is called Allegro, not too Allegro, it says, but Allegro, which means kind of quick. Well, the second one is also quick. It just says Allegro Vivo, which means really quick. So we love to think about this first one as this kind of big, broad opening, broad landscapes and soundscapes of the American. And maybe this composer is actually a Czech, but he lived in the States and was so inspired by the landscapes and the soundscapes that he observed there. The first movement is just great because it shows so many little tunes and rhythms and things that he was inspired by both in his homeland and also in America. The second movement is an Allegro Vivo, which really means quickly, like quite quickly. It's kind of what it means, quickly, and then actually like pretty fast quickly. This is just like, it's like trots along and sort of has this really cute little tune. And then later it's as though we're sort of thinking of this as like a cowboy, like trotting along through the countryside, whistling a little tune. And, there's just some beautiful, big, beautiful melodies and also really like wild stomping kind of folk dancey sort of, sections you'll hear a little later on. And then he kind of brings it down to one of the most like soulful singing melodies that I've ever heard and accompanies it with sort of this strumming in the strings that almost sounds like sitting around a campfire singing a ballad about something you love. So, second movement of Dvorak's Viola Quintet. Thank you. Such a pleasure to be getting to perform music again together after all of this time spent distancing from one another during the pandemic. We not only have the pleasure of playing with one another, but we also have a couple of composers in our group. Nicholas Denton Protzak, who's here on the cello, is going to be playing some of his music later on in August, and we'll get to perform some of his works as well, I hope. But here in this room, we also have Thomas Beckman. Thomas Beckman just played viola with us in this last piece, but he's written a piece specifically also for the quartet here that's here, and he's going to tell you a little bit more about it. Here's Thomas Beckman.
Thanks, Roxy. I've collaborated with the Vancouver Maritime Museum before. A couple of years back, I wrote a piece on probably their main installation, the St. Rock, which is a RCM schooner that traversed the Northwest Passage. And this time around, I was inspired by another of their installations, the Ben Franklin Submersible, which is a 7-man submarine that in 1969 was commissioned to basically do a little tour along the east coast of the United States. And it sits, the submersible sits outside the Vancouver Maritime Museum. And I sort of got curious about it, and you can't normally go in, but this time around they actually invited me to go in and take a look, so it was fascinating to go inside. And when you listen to the piece, if you're curious to take a look at the actual submarine and see what it looks like, you can go onto Vancouver Maritime Museum's website and you'll actually find some footage there. But it was quite a fascinating voyage. It was overshadowed by Apollo 11 in 1969. But whilst they were there, they had a NASA scientist on board who conducted a psychological test on how people interact in short enclosed spaces for long periods of time. And the actual submersible spent about 2 or 3 weeks 2,000 feet below the surface collecting, or not really collecting, but observing some of the plankton and life that exists down there. So it's really quite an interesting story. But for the piece, what I was more interested in was the experience of descending to that degree below the surface, what that would feel like if you actually look at the submersible. There are tiny little portholes along the craft, but there isn't a big sort of view. So it must have felt kind of cramped and somewhat dark, especially now. I mean, when I was in there, most of the instrumentation had been removed, but you know, whilst it was in operation, it was filled with stuff, you know, tanks and dials and machines and all kinds of things. So My hope with Submerge, the name of this piece, that we get a bit of sense of, yes, you're tight, you're sort of claustrophobic inside the craft, but outside you're just in endless spaces of water. And so having that sense, the sense of depth, the sense of descending into some unknown place, the darkness of it all, to me, must have been, whilst an exciting mission for the scientists, must have also been psychologically a little scary. So that's what I sort of hope to, that's what inspired me as I was writing the piece. And very grateful to these musicians who've, you know, with any piece like this is always something that's a little strange and new. So I'm sure Nick has played lots of music even more avant-garde than this. But anyway, it's been a real great experience for me as composer to have people put so much care into it. So thank you.
I'm playing the wrong piece of music. There we go. This is the right one.
Thank you so much to Orchestra North. This has been a presentation of the Orchestra North Academy Quintet, and the piece that we just heard was written by Thomas Beckman, and it's called Submerged. So we just wanted to briefly ask you some questions very quickly. First, I would just like to thank our sponsors for this for these lounge car sessions. I'd like to thank BC Touring Council, City West, and the British Columbia Arts Council as well. So I see that I believe Roxy has the microphone there. So I'd like to ask you if you could tell me about that first piece. It was great the way that you described it before, but playing that first piece, it was quite jaunty. So it seems like that's fun to play. Is it as much fun as it is to listen to?
Oh, absolutely. This music is just a riot. I feel like a nice description for sections of the Dvorak is like 19th century rock and roll. Like it's just kind of, it just kind of moves and makes you want to tap your feet. And one of the things that we're cooperating with this year, as every other year with the Orchestra North Academy, is the Spirit of the North Classical Music Festival. And within that context, and this year actually in partnership with the Bulkley Valley Concert Association, we're able to put on live concerts. We're so excited about being able to do that. And a really big theme that we've noticed as we've put together these concerts with the selections of the musicians and the different people coming in is optimism seems to be the real theme. Optimism, hope, and a lot of fun. And so I think that this Dvorak piece is extra special in a way, also because it seems to be a real centerpiece for the festival and the whole idea of why we're meeting together. It's fun, it's optimistic, it gives everybody a chance to sing and to shine, and it's just, yes, it's a lot of fun to play. I hope it was as much fun to listen to.
Oh, I think absolutely it was. And just for anyone listening, if you do want to find out more information about that, about this festival, Spirit of the North Music Festival, you can go to festivalnorth.com. And as well, you can follow Orchestra North on Instagram if you look for Orchestra North Academy.
Yes.
Or just I think it's Orchestra North Academy.
We are pretty sure it is Orchestra North Academy.
Orchestra North BC. Thank you.
There we go, Nick. Thanks, Nick.
Okay, and so just very quickly, because we only have a few minutes left, I did just want to speak about the piece that we just heard as well, and maybe that'd be something that Thomas could speak to a little bit more as well. But as you mentioned, that it's called Submerged, and I think that myself and probably everyone else who's hearing this piece really does feel that going down, that descension that you have there. And there was even these moments where it almost sounded like there was pinging happening, almost like using sonar. So when you're writing a piece like that, you know, where's your mind? And you said that you visited the Maritime Museum in Vancouver as well.
Yeah.
So were you in there writing it, or what was that process like, if you could briefly tell us about that?
Well, I did want to actually go inside the submersible. It sits outside the museum. It's a strange-looking thing, sort of a bulbous yellow-white thing. And like I said, it's the portholes along it are very, very small.
Mm-hmm.
So you sort of get you imagine that if you were inside there, and even if you had these big, strong lights as you're traveling along, you know, the sea, or even, I mean, it had the capacity to go 4,000 feet, but it only went 2,000 feet below the surface. But you imagine that if you were inside, you wouldn't have the biggest view of what was outside, because like I said, the portholes were so small. So it just felt very claustrophobic, and I got special permission to actually go inside the craft, which was really cool.
Yeah, that's excellent.
Yeah, oh. Then after that, I came away and I started working on it.
Right, yeah.
So, yeah.
Well, and it's funny, too, because you were mentioning about how, you know, the psychology of being in a closed space with people.
Yeah.
And our stage is actually quite small. So I'm thinking that the headspace was just about right for how we could fit everybody
in
here.
Yeah, I mean, the actual mess of the craft was at the front of the submersible, and it was really not much bigger than the stage.
Oh, excellent.
So, yeah, yeah.
Neat.
So.
This group of musicians is here because of the Orchestra North Academy program, and also funding from the BC Arts Council, making it possible for professional musicians to come for a time of rejuvenation and professional development. But ironically, we're also living in cramped quarters because of the pandemic. We thought it'd be safest if we were a pod and stayed in the same house.
Oh.
All of us are now experiencing closed quarters as well, Thomas. Here's the mic.
Well, you function very well for roommates then.
Yeah.
Okay, well, that is all the time that we have. Thank you so much, Orchestra North. Once again, that website, if you want to find out about more about the Spirit of the North Music Festival, you can go to festivalnorth.com. I believe you can also find Bulkley Valley Concert Association as well. You can go to their Facebook page for more information about those events as well. Thank you so much. Once again, our players today have been Aaron on violin, Roxy on violin, Thomas on viola, Julian on viola, and Nick on cello. Thank you so much, Orchestra North. And this has been CICK 93.9 FM, our lounge car session with Orchestra North.